So welcome back, everybody. It's really hot in the Netherlands these days. On Saturday, the Tour de France will start in Utrecht, which is quite nearby. And we all feel sorry and pity for all those guys on bicycles. On Saturday, we expect an all-time high in the Netherlands, like 37 degrees.
Oh.
Which is, and the record for the Netherlands is 38. Which was achieved like 70 years ago, so we hope and pray that it will not happen, of course. Welcome back in this session. Jaap asked me to remind you of two things. First of all, the little booklet also has the abstracts, so you can read and find what to expect. Second, for those who are a little late, this afternoon we will meet again in the Boerhaven. There is a small leaflet on that, stating that at 3 o'clock there will be lectures on sport and science, data science, very interesting. Oscar already told us we have to leave at around 2 o'clock to be on time. So please think of that. The session now is on the games. You are expected to be on a games conference, so it is no big surprise that this session really is on games. We have two speakers. First of all, Ingo Althöfer, we all know, of course. He is from Jena in Germany, and I would please give him the floor. You think you can start the...
I will start with that.
You can start. Thank you very much.
Thanks. You say it will be on games. When you hear the talk, some of you will think, is it really on games? And I try to convince you, at least at the end, that it has to do with games in some abstract way. So, I go to the full screen mode. It is on diffusion control in random board games. And what is the start? Contents. How can we come from game programming to the casino, Monte Carlo for instance, and to the stock market? I will show a simple casino model, introduce it with theoretical as well as numerical results. In the second half of the talk, I will switch to diffusion control in compact spaces. So this is more for people from the stock market world, and this is more for natural sciences. And I hope at the end to find a bridge back to computer Go and computer-aided Go. So, we are here, game program. And there were people before us who were there. And somehow in their life, they switched track, either directly to the stock market or via casino experiences. And there's a nice book by William Poundstone, Fortune's Formula, highly recommended. And two of the people described there and part of their life in a biographical way is Claude Shannon, the father of computer chess, and Ed Thorpe, say the father of counting in blackjack. Maybe not the father, but at least the person who made a lot of money with his book on that. Then several others followed, and somewhere in between you will find one of us, Trilly Donninger. Those of you who were active before 2005 here know him well. He was chess programmer. He was one of the two heads, of the many heads of the Hydro team. Ulf Lorenz was the parallelization head. Erdo was the opening head and the operating head. Yes, and Trilly for the FPGA and also for evaluation functions. Yes, and then he switched track, he became a quant. And it happened in the following way. Hydra project was paid by a sheikh from Abu Dhabi. And you know the sheikh had, I think, billions of dollars. And he was like a little child, playing with this, playing with that, having this Hydra project as one of the smaller activities. And after some years he got bored. Krilli had one of his 2 monthly dates in Abu Dhabi, and the sheikh asked, okay Krilli, chess is boring now, we have beaten Adams by 5.5, 2.5. What shall we do now? Krilli was not prepared, but then we may apply our algorithms to the game of Go. And the sheikh, where shall we go? No, I mean the Asian board game, the famous board game of Go. Yes, I understand, but where shall we go? So the sheikh did not understand. And Krilli tried a second thing. Or we may try to apply our chess algorithms to the game of poker. Yes. Poker is fine. But after 2 minutes, the advisor of the sheikh said, boss, we have a little problem, we are Muslim. We are not allowed to play poker. Shit. So Krilli had no more fantasy. Poker was already hard for him to imagine. And then he made one last try without any hope. Of course, we can also apply our algorithm to the stock market. And the sheikh immediately took both mobile phones, switched them off. Tell me more. And Krilli was not prepared. So he found some intelligent way to make many words without showing that he did not know much about the topic. But the sheikh was enough impressed, okay, we will have our next date in 2 weeks. You will fly in again. And on the plane back to Vienna, Krilli was thinking which books to buy at Amazon to get a first course in stock market mathematics. Yes, and he was successful. The sheikh is still paying a monthly bill of several thousand dollars to him. But I am a mathematician. I was involved in discussions with Krilli, and yes, he also liked some theoretical models. Of course, the sheikh was not interested in formula or models, but what was the background of Krilli's software was some sort of models, and I will show you a very simple one, the 1-2 casino model. You have a broker at the stock market, not paying for his own pocket, but employed by a bank. So he gets monthly salary, everything is fine. But the point is, he wants to get a bonus. And this is ideally, on each day, he has to make exactly one action. Either a small one with small stake or a big one. And stock market is sort of casino, let's say a fair casino. So the stake is either doubled or lost, decided by a fair coin flip, so both with probability 1/2. And small stake means 1 unit, big stake means 2 units. And what the broker knows, there are T trading days. And after these T days, the year ends, and the broker will get a bonus when she has increased the capital or at least not decreased the capital. So remember, it's not the money of the broker, but the money of her bank. And she gets the bonus when she stays in the plus or at least is not in the minus at the end. So the broker is sort of egoist. Her only desire is to get the bonus. If the bank gets minus 1 million or 1 billion or 20 billion, no problem, bonus is zero. But when the plus is 1 euro, she gets the bonus. When it's 1 million plus, also the same bonus. So So the broker wants to maximize the probability for getting this bonus. I translate this to a random walk model. There is a particle on the string of integers. We are starting in zero. That is our starting capital. We have t random steps, independent of each other. And in each step, the controller, the broker, either makes a small step, going with one half here, with one half there, or a big step, going with one half here and with one half there. So direct translation of the 1 unit or 2 unit stakes. The controller wants to maximize the probability to finish in a non-negative state after the t rounds. And we were able to prove the following theorem. Independently of the remaining number of days, it is optimal to make large steps when you are in the negative numbers and small steps when you are in a non-negative number. So when things were fine so far, make a small step, no risk, or small risk. And when you are in the negatives, play bold. And bold is here restricted to size 2. Idea of the proof, we have Bellman recursions. And therefore, we need that we know the number of days that are still remaining. We start at still 0 days remaining, compute from those values till 1 day remaining, and the optimal strategies and the expectations. And the basic strategy, namely to do this, gives a structure similar to the Pascal's triangle, you will see on the next slide. And third part of the proof is deviation from this basic strategy does not help. So that is when we look time in another way. We start here at capital 0. Then we go to minus 1 and to plus 1 with probability 1 half each. I'm not writing 1 half because the board would become too full. And this is 1 quarter, 1 quarter, 1 quarter, 1 quarter, and so on. And you see one thing here in the negative, only the odd numbers occur. And in the positive, the even ones. And that has to do with our optimal strategy. Here we make steps of size 1. So this goes here, here, this goes here, here, this goes here, here. But the negative, the minus 1 goes to minus 3 or plus 2. Minus 3 goes to minus 5 or minus 1, and so on. So it is sort of Pascal's triangle, but here in the center, something special is happening. And that was what made the theoretical proof a bit complicated. And when you count these probabilities, for instance here, 1 quarter, 3 quarter. These are the 3 quarters here. And on the next level, 3 versus 5. So 5 divided by 8. And so on. And these fractions are those which are nearest possible to 2/3. And in the end, we get limit 2/3. So, playing bold in the negatives, playing small in the positives, gives us a chance of success by 2/3. The random walk has no drift. Only by controlling the size of the steps helps us to give these 2/3. More general, we look at the MN casino. Before we had M equal to 1, N equal to 2. One particle walking again, start in 0, T random steps. In each step, either small or big, decided by our controller. And the small step goes minus m to the left or minus m to the right, and in the big step, what's the big step? There. Minus n plus n, also with probability 1/2. So straightforward. And the controller wants to maximize the probability to finish in some non-negative state. We were able to prove a theorem for the 1-3 casino, m equal 1, n equal 3. Independently of time t, it is optimal to make large steps in the negatives and small steps in the positives. This is the corresponding Pascal-like triangle, and it looks smoother than in the 1-2 case. Here we have minus 1, minus 4, minus 7. Because for minus 1, you will go not to plus 1, but to plus 2. So it fits almost perfectly. Here you see directly the Pascal structure. Here is the sum of two normal Pascals plus 1 from there. And it's easier to prove that this goes on for infinity. And the probability of success converges to 3/4. So even better. In the 1-3 casino, we have 75% chance to be successful. We have numerical results for many other pairs of M and N. For these we have the proofs. These are the number T of steps. And this is the limit written in a special form, 2/3. Shit, what happened? There are some data not, it should be 2 divided by plus 1 plus 2. And here we have 3 divided by 1 plus 3. Yeah. Obviously.
Yeah.
So we made an error. No problem. You will see what the limit is 0.8 and it is 4 divided by 5 and so on. In some cases you see we have fast conversions, here for instance. It's 3 divided by 2 plus 3. And in some other cases, the convergence is rather slow. But in general, the conjecture is for each pair Mn, it's optimal to make large steps for almost all I in the negative and small steps for almost all. It's not all, but almost all, because when n and m are large numbers, some number theoretic properties lead to some inaccuracies around 0. But the resulting probability should be n divided by n plus m, n being the larger number, 2/3, 3/4, and so on. So when n is larger than m, it's better than 1/2, and the larger the difference, the better the score. Now I switch to the physical world. Diffusion control in compact spaces. The integers were not compact. Here we have 0, here we have plus infinity, here we have minus infinity, and the particle can go out arbitrarily far from 0. And compact means we have some bounds here, where we have reflection or something like that. And one thing is to bind it together at the end. So this is the bed area, area L, where we will make large steps with our particle. This is a good area where we make small steps. And our intention is to be with high probability in this part at the end. For people from physics, here you have warm temperature, and here cold. So the Brownian motion here makes large steps, there are small steps, and that should help to concentrate there.
You take care of your time, you have maybe 4 minutes. Oh,
okay. So this is a stationary distribution, and it shows that the first conjecture with 1/3 and 2/3 was wrong. It is indeed 4 divided by 5 and 1 divided by 5. And in general, we have proved for the 1n circle model, the probability for the good region approaches n squared divided by n squared plus 1. You remember, before in the integer model, we had n divided by n plus 1. Now we have n squared divided by n squared plus 1. we compute simply the stationary distributions, more or less straightforward. Here you see some more results. And again, we have the problem that the limit is in the wrong way. It should be 1 minus this. Sorry. So here it will be 7 squared divided by 3 squared plus 7 squared. In the conjecture in general, we have this n squared divided by n squared plus m squared. I come to the last point. Can we go back to our world of games, gameplay? And I like computer-aided play, so having some strong software, anti-human helping the software. And my experience from Dreihirn is the human has to be very careful not to have too much control. Only very few situations, only very few influence. Grady Stone is a strong robot, Manja Mark, the best German female player, and they together were able to beat one of the strongest Germans, Stefan Kreitschik, by 2-1. And you see, such a situation helped her to control her ego. This was a KJS screen. Here is Crazy Stone running. Here is the daughter of Manja. So Manja can concentrate on the Go game some way, but the doll of daughter is sitting there at my office, is yes, full of garbage, whatever you have. Important, the controller has to control, and Manja is one of the persons who can do this. My final question, we know people who came from game programming and of course came to the stock market. Will we ever see people from the stock market coming to us, let me help you program Ingo? Thanks.
If you go back to the first example with the trader optimizing for a bonus, being a 2 out of 3.
Yes.
What would be the expectation for the band itself?
Pardon, the expectation for what?
For? So, for the trader?
Yes.
Playing for a bonus, the expectation is quite positive.
Yes, but for the band, it's zero.
It
will have positive scores with high probability, but small positive scores. And when the score is negative, it will typically be much larger in absolute value. So for the bank, it is plus minus zero. And the problem for the bank is the high swings are in the negatives.
Yeah, that's why I would expect
it. Yes.
Negative is not for the bank.
Yes.
You say
and this is one of the problems when the bank is naive to set up some bonus system and believes our employees are faithful and trustful, but it will never happen. They are all egoists. They look how to get their bonus, how to improve their bonus, and you have to be very careful to set up a good bonus system.
Okay. Another question, please.
What happens to your strategy when this is not a fair casino? So next time I go to the casino, what is my strategy? If it's not 50-50, it's slightly worse to lose money. So according to your strategy, it would be good to set only one jeton on black?
No, it
and
is.
If I'm losing 2 jetons, but what happens to your probability of not getting negative if losing is somewhat more higher than winning?
Yeah, that is known from the 1960s. It's known under the name bold strategy. You have to go all in the sense that you put in as much money as it needed to gain a positive score in this one round. And when you have it, you stop. But when you lose in your first round, you double your entry, your stake, in the next round, double again, and so on.
What happens to your strategy in this case? If I use strategy in the casino, what happens to my stack?
You see, this is only an emergency strategy. When the broker would be allowed to set higher stakes than 2, he would set stake 1 when he is in the positive, and he would set stake k plus 1 when he is at minus k. So you try to get with very few steps, at best with 1 step to the positive, and then stop playing. And he's not allowed. He has to make one action each day, and that is the best how he can approximate this bold strategy.
Thank you. Last question. If not, we can ask the speaker if he thinks the stock market is a game.
The question is
the stock market a game or not? You are only allowed.
Kulli says yes. Okay. And as he says, it is worse than Monte Carlo.
Meaning?
Yes, they are the best shockers you find at the stock market and not in the casino.
Thank you very much.